Hello everyone, I am Dr. Hemant Vyas, MD Homeopath, Assistant Professor Surgery, Department of Surgery, Faculty of Homeopathic Science, Jayoti Vidyapeeth, Sinusitis. Today's our PowerPoint is about diseases of gums. So let's begin. So let's see what is the difference between a healthy gum and a diseased gum or an unhealthy gum. Healthy gums are pink or coral pink colored. They are firm, resilient tissues. The shape that follows the contour of the teeth. No area of redness, swelling or inflammation. No bleeding during daily plaque removal or brushing the teeth. And no discomfort. In the normal state, there is no consciousness of our gums. If the gums become unhealthy, there is feeling of unhealthiness in the gums. Let's see the first disease of gums, that is gingivitis. Gingivitis refers to gingival inflammation induced by bacterial biofilms, also called as plaque, which are adherent to tooth surface. Bacterial plaque accumulates in the spaces between the gums and teeth and in calculus, that is tartar, that forms on the teeth. These accumulations may be tiny, even microscopic, but the bacteria contained in them produces foreign chemicals and the toxins that cause inflammation of the gums around teeth. Symptoms of gingivitis: bright red or purple gums, shiny gums, gums that are painless except when pressure is applied, gums that easily bleed even with gentle brushing and especially when you floss. Receding gum line is a symptom of gingivitis. Now let's see how to prevent gingivitis. Gingivitis can be prevented through regular oral hygiene that includes daily brushing and flossing. When the teeth are not cleaned properly, bacterial plaque accumulates and becomes mineralized by calcium and other minerals in the saliva, transforming it into a hard material called calculus or tartar, which harbors bacteria and irritates the gingiva, that is gums. Treatment of gingivitis: the removal of plaque is usually not painful. The inflammation of gums should be gone between 1 and 2 weeks. Oral hygiene includes proper brushing and flossing is required to prevent the recurring of gingivitis. Complications of gingivitis: recurrence of gingivitis is common. Periodontitis or pyorrhea is also a complication of gingivitis. Infection or abscess of the gingiva or the jaw bones. Next disease is periodontitis or pyorrhea. It is a set of inflammatory diseases affecting the tissues surrounding the teeth. Periodontitis involves progressive loss of alveolar bone around the teeth and, if left untreated, can lead to loosening and subsequent loss of teeth. Now let's see how the severity is evaluated. The severity of disease refers to the amount of periodontal ligament fibers that have been lost, termed as clinical attachment loss. According to the American Academy of Periodontology, and classification of severity is as follows. First, mild periodontitis is 1 to 2 mm of attachment loss. Moderate, 3 to 4 mm of attachment loss. And severe periodontitis is more than 5 mm of attachment loss. Early and moderate periodontitis: the ligaments holding the tooth in its socket break down and the gum pull away from the teeth, resulting in a periodontal pocket or space between the tooth and gum. The periodontal pocket deepens and fills with more bacteria. Supportive ligament and bone start to show damage. You can see the pictures of early periodontitis and moderate periodontitis. Periodontitis occurs when the inflammation of the gums progresses into the deeper underlying structure and bone. In the most common form, the periodontitis plaque is found below the gum line. The gums may feel irritated, appear bright red, and bleed easily. Advanced periodontitis. When periodontitis progresses to the advanced stage, the gum severely recedes, pull away from the tooth pockets, deepen, and may be filled with pus. You can see an image of advanced periodontitis on the right side. Signs and symptoms. There may be swelling around the root, and you may experience sensitivity to hot or cold or feel pain when brushing your teeth. This is due to severely receding gum exposing the root surface. As bone loss increases, teeth may lose so much support that they need to be removed to preserve the overall health of your mouth. Treatment of periodontal diseases. First, prevention, detection, assessment, scaling, debridement, root surface planning. Periodontal surgery may be required. Bone grafting may be required. Prevention of periodontitis. First thing is most essential, that is regular home care, that is brushing, flossing, rinsing, and aids to oral hygiene. Regular dental visits are required. Dietary considerations should be there. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you.